What's going on, Cancer? I salute the divinity in you, and welcome to the Chariot and Friends. Justin here, and I hope you're feeling pumped up. we're getting pumped up. We're bringing excitement to Scorpio. We're bringing happiness to Scorpio. We're turning that anxiety into it, an anticipation. Because, you know, I feel like every time I was really kind of meditating on this, and I was like, you know, every time when Scorpio comes around, there's always this, like, this apprehension. And it's just like, there's more than just the fear and things with Scorpio. We feel a number of emotions. So we're going to really kind of get into that today. But before we jump into that, if you're new to this channel, welcome. My name is Justin. And know that when you're coming across this video, you're in sync with the moon. And she loves that. And this is also a place for if you have Cancer in your placements, Sun, Moon, Rising, Mars, wherever. This one's for you. And I do tarot card spreads based upon our ruler here, the good old Moon. And I'll talk about what sign she's in, what phase she's in, when she's going void, of course, just all of those lunar shenanigans. And just so you're all aware, this is a general reading, not a one-to-one, so take what fits into your story, discard the rest, and everything will be dope, Cancer. Now, I really love, I just changed spaces and I really enjoy looking outside. It's been a very, very nice change of pace here. I'm going to get some art here soon, so stay tuned for that. Let's jump into it. It's like, I'm getting off track there. But, Cancer, depending on when you're watching this, happy Venus Day. Venus is associated with Fridays, and this is the day to go out and just go out and feel beautiful. Go to a concert. Go to, like, maybe there's a city band that's playing. Go to, like, a jazz club. Go to an opera. Maybe you can do, like, a symphony. See some art. Go enjoy nature. Go maybe go look at some flowers. I'll tell you what, I was just at the market the other day, and I mean, there's just these people walking around with just these bouquet of flowers. That's the way to be enjoying this Venusian energy right now. I was just like, yes. Yes, look at all this color. It's fantastic. And so anything to get you feeling in that sort of attractive space, Venus wants us to feel magnetic, to feel that we can attract all that we want. And so, and that we deserve the things that we attract to. So I feel with this energy, because Venus is strong right now, it's really work with this energy. Maybe go hang out with some friends. Let's get everyone all pumped up. Let's raise everyone's vibration here. And this is a really constructive energy. I really feel like we're about to be into, because on this day, we got a little planetary shift here, and I'll actually be shuffling while I'm talking about this. Mercury is going to be entering back into its sign that not only is it at home in, but it's celebrated in Virgo. Ooh. Ooh. Absolutely. Thanks to bite some. We'll talk about that. Ha! I love that. I'll tell you why I'm freaking out in a moment. But with Mercury and Virgo, it's going to be entering into Virgo at about 11:50 p.m., and that'll be Pacific time. And with this, like I was saying, Mercury is domicile and exalted in Virgo. There's no other planet that does that, that works so well in a sign like Mercury does in Virgo. It's a little different than when Mercury's in Gemini, because Mercury is fast, very, very fast in Gemini. It can learn and teach teach as quick as it learns. It's really cool when it's working in Gemini, but here Mercury's able to materialize a lot of those ideas. It becomes more than just like a teaching. It becomes more than just the words. It becomes your business, your empire, your service, whatever this thing is. That's why I feel while we have Mercury in Virgo, Venus in Libra, and even when Mercury moves into Libra, this is going to be a really great time to get things in order. Look at where you have Virgo in your chart and see where Mercury has got you thinking. And this is going to be a really important place too, because the sun is here right now. So your inspirations, your the light is under the auspices of of Mercury. So really, really work with this. Be very intentional with where you're trying to build, with what you're trying to go. Maybe have like a vision board up. Maybe have, I work with like my solar and lunar return charts. So I have those usually up. Maybe put some affirmations up, something to keep the goals, whatever that might be looking like. Maybe get yourself some posters, however that looks, just to keep you in that energy of excitement in things. So that's something too, I actually was thinking about, just a little side bar two with the Venus day. Go out there, do some shopping. I actually was reading a book and it really kind of changed my perception of window shopping a little bit. I used to not really care for it as a kid. My grandma would take me window shopping all the time. It'd be hot some days. but when I think about it now, I've always had, was like, that's the oddest thing, to just go in there to just kind of try on some things and not buy something. But she was always getting in the energy of it. She's Pisces son, or Pisces sun. And I think Venus can be really great in that. If you're in the energy, like, oh, this coat looks really good on me. Don't worry about where the resources are coming from. They're going to come to you under grace and in the most perfect of ways. But you need to, I feel there needs to be able to, that energy of that you deserve this, of like, oh, yeah, I can't. Oh, wait, well, man, when I'm strutting this on the street, man, I'm be turning heads. So really get yourself kind of geeked up in this energy. Get really this, and this is going to be perfect. Let me move on into the lunar shenanigans. Because on the 6th of September, the moon is going to be moving into Scorpio at about 10:18 p.m., and that's going to be Pacific time, and she'll be moving into a waxing crescent phase. So now we're starting to see that sliver of light. The ideas are going to start coming in. This is the I'm going to talk about this and when we talk about the void, of course, but it's just, she's in that sextile energy now. That's when the planets are, the sun and the moon are about 60 degrees apart. Things are getting exciting. It's Venusian in nature. So we're attracting things. Now, with the moon being in Scorpio, she is in her fall. So her energy is a little bit harder to work with. It's because going from where she's strongest in Cancer, where she's able to just like, okay, I'm feeling an emotion, I'll start this for a couple days, and then we're going to shift gears, and then I'm going to move from this thing's going to flow into this thing's going to flow into this thing. We got a nice just kind of continuous flow. We're just always moving with Cancer. But then when she gets to Scorpio, she can get moving, but sometimes she gets stuck on things for a longer time. And this isn't a problem, I feel, when she's feeling her happiness, when she's feeling this excitement, this joy in things. But just as she can feel those intensely with Scorpio, being that fixed water sign, she can also feel the tougher emotions. All of them are really beautiful in their own way. You know, they're necessary for the experience. They bring up different things. They help us to, I feel like, to express, just express a fuller side of ourselves. But I feel with this, when you find yourself maybe stuck on one that maybe where you're maybe stuck in a place of lack, or you're stuck in a place of where you're feeling like resentment, or you're feeling anger, or you're feeling frustrated, or things along those lines, it's like, what can you do to get those? I feel like the moon by herself, it's you have to work a little harder at that and have these different tools and different ways to move this energy. Whether it's, I find with Scorpio, when you think about what Scorpio is associated with in the body, Scorpio is associated with like the sweat glands. This is not medical advice or anything, but associated with the sweat glands, like the nostrils, anything that you excrete from. I know how that sounds, but it may not sound too pleasant, but if you were to hold that stuff, when you're congested, that's not a great feeling. When you're constipated, that's not a great feeling. Scorpio gets that stuff moving so that you can feel great again, so that you can feel at your best. And so maybe this is working with some bitter teas, possibly. Maybe this is where St. John, not medical advice or anything, but St. John's wort, if you have yourself finding through, and talk with your doctor with that, definitely if you're on any sort of like pharmaceuticals or anything. But St. John's wort could be one that can really help you move through some tough emotions, because it has that bitterness. It's a very bitter type of herb, but sometimes that bitterness can just, it just helps make, or it helps those emotions a bit easier to swallow, in a sense. Or even working with like holy basil. That's another one. That's a really nice herb. It has this, it has a really lovely taste too. But that can be another one that could help brighten up, kind of lighten up the emotions. And one thing I like with the moon being in Scorpio right now is that her and Mars are in mutual reception. And what that means is that the planets are supporting one another. And really the Mars and the moon are part of, and if I were looking at a chart, the moon's part of the night sect, and so is Mars. And so there's already this relationship that's already happening, but they're understanding each other's struggles in each other's signs, so they can help each other out. The moon is saying, okay, this is what I'm feeling, and Mars instinctively, our energy, knows how to move it. Okay, like, I'm feeling this, I need to do this. So this is a really great time, I feel, to listen to your instincts. If you're like, I'm really kind of craving some kind of spicy foods, or this is just an example, then maybe making like a hot soup, for example, throw some peppers in there, get some a sharp type of soup, maybe putting some rosemary or something like thyme or something, a little oregano to help kind of clear up the senses, get some things moving in a sense. You know, maybe I'll do the same thing. Maybe I'll make some soup. That actually sounds really nice. Maybe even moving the body is another really great one, I feel, when you have some emotions coming up. I actually just not here too long ago, I had the moon was forming, my progress moon was forming a conjunction with my Mars, and has been over the last couple months, and I've been noticing there's been kind of a buildup in energy. I haven't been moving the body like I would like to, doing it like, I've been getting my workouts in, but I've been needing to do some yoga too. I've been wanting to get back on track with that, and I noticed where some things were getting kind of pent up or being kind of stored, and there was one day where I was like, you know what? I went up to the stairs. I was like, I'll be right back. And I went up to stairs. I was like, bah! I just punched my bed really quick and just like, okay, now what? Sometimes just getting that force out there, even if you don't understand what's going on, can help you like, okay, I shook the snow globe, or I kind of rattled myself, like got that out there, just kind of raw expression, found a safe space. Now what can I do with that? How can I transmute this energy? So that's why I want this kind of this moon in Scorpio. And you know, when we're thinking about Scorpio energy in general, it's an invitation to get us, to move through something, especially if there are things that we've been struggling with, that we've been holding on to. Because even though it's a fixed water sign, I feel like I almost like to think of it as more so like a power washer. Scorpio is meant to, because have you ever seen how the power of water, if you've ever cleaned up a deck or watched someone work with the power washer, water will purify all of that stuff up. And so that's where I feel this moon in Scorpio, or anytime we're in any kind of Scorpio energy, when you're noticing like just certain areas are just like really kind of gotten a little murky, kind of mucky, like, all right, let's clean this up. Let's find some ways to move this energy out of. What are some things that... Focus on the things that bring you joy, that bring you happiness, and doing more of those things so that we can attract more of that and move towards that direction. So, but yeah, that's what I'm really thinking with this with this moon in Scorpio. I think these next few days, really kind of trust what your body needs at this time. Because, and really just kind of in general. You know, really kind of pay attention to that and the things that you're attracting into your world. And when you're, especially notice when you are feeling in any sort of, caught up in any sort of like emotions that seem to be lowering your vibration down a little bit. Now, last little thing I want to talk about is the Void of Course, which is going to be happening on a Sunday, which is the 8th of September. And the Void of Course is going to be happening from 7:28 a.m. And it'll be going on until Moonday, that's the 9th of September, until about 10:25 a.m. So we're looking at about a 26-hour, 57-minute Void of Course time. And the aspect that she's forming, it's usually the last aspect that she forms with the celestial body, and I'm working with the traditional planets, is the aspect that flavors that void of course time. And she's forming a sextile with the sun. And so I really like that energy with where everything is piling up here, because maybe it might feel a little hard at first with considering Mars being in fall, the moon being in fall. You have to trust what you're feeling, but if you focus on the things that lift you up, it can really help. I feel like it'll be like a domino effect that'll be happening here. And it's just like focusing on the things that'll help you get in better alignment. Like, okay, if you're noticing that that coffee's been making you, getting you a little jittery, you've been getting kind of burnt out there. Okay, maybe trying to switch to more decaf, and maybe do like a half and half at first, or maybe working with some teas possibly, or however that's look, you know, whatever that's looking like. I don't say you necessarily go like a cold turkey. It's a process that you need to sometimes do with these things. You want to have something to catch that cushion before you like shock the body. It's like if you were to go from a really cold bath to a really hot bath, sometimes that might feel okay. I remember doing that a few winters ago. But I feel that this is more so wanting a sextile energy is a gentler touch, you know, as opposed to like a trine energy where there's really big kind of fat, kind of more faster movement. And and generally the void of course periods are a time where you're kind of reflecting on what has happened while the moon was in Scorpio. What were some things that came up? Were you feeling apprehensive about some things? And now if you haven't figured out how, what are some ways that you can maybe assuage some of those fears? Like, okay, I feel this thing. It's real. It feels real to you. What actionable steps can I do? Or can I take to adjust that future and then channel that into your body? Imagine yourself taking care of let's play pretend. Let's imagine this. You know, like, okay, what is this me looking like tackling this thing, conquering this thing, Mars? Because Scorpio is a powerful sign. And if you can hold that feeling in there, you can change the narrative. You can change where your things are going. You'll imprint that on your body and you'll just know what to do. And I feel like this is something like not to overthink this thing, whatever this action is that you're needing to take. That may be coming up while this moon is in Scorpio. So very interesting what can come up here. I'm excited to see how this lunar cycle is going to pan out here, especially once we get closer to that, get to that full moon and kind of close this thing out. So just be excited. I'm not forcing you to, but try to get yourself excited about what's to come. You know, I really think that we are in a very pivotal turning point collectively. And I think that can really start seeing some really surprising results here in a few years. So let's switch over here. And I think that's all I wanted to tell you. But if you're curious about how this stuff is working in your chart and you want to work with this more personally, I have a link down in the description box to book a free consultation call with me and discuss all the services that I provide. Or I also have a group that I run monthly. It would do just regular group settings. It's called the Lunar Mansion, and it's where we have these meetings. You sign up for whatever lunar cycle that you're signing up for. So we have the Libra new moon eclipse that's getting ready to come up on October 1st. That's when I'll be having the class. And I have different time slots open up for those times, so being different groups of four. And we'll just pull up the example charts of the charts of everyone in the group. We'll talk about, you know, of course, generally, kind of whatever comfortable you feel about talking about. And we'll just talk about the general themes, the areas that are lit up, and how we're going to work over this. And we'll meet four times over a 27-month period and really work with this area of your chart and monitor how the things grow over this time. It's really spectacular when you work with the moon very intentionally, and it's even more potent when you have the support of a great group too. So that's something that sounds like resonates with you, all that information is down in the description box. I look forward to seeing you there. But last little things, these readings that I do, they're not gender-specific readings. So apply these energies to people as they make sense for your situations. But let's go ahead and get into your general energy of the day, because I love this. And because the gemstone that I chose for this deck is blue kyanite. And this is blue kyanite and honeysuckle. And actually, I really had a little sidebar bringing up some emotions here. There's a honeysuckle bush that is by my parents' place, and just like a couple of summers ago, my stepdad and I were working out in the yard, and he was like, "You smell that?" And it's just like, because it was so interesting. I was smelling, I was like, "Oh, there's such sweetness in the air." And he's like, "You smell that?" And it's like, "Yeah." It's like, "Yes, that honeysuckle bush. We've had that for," and I've always like, it's always been there. The thing is, but something about that in that moment really stuck out, and that's just really become one of those just sweeter memories that I really love to call on between him and I. So, but. You got the blue kyanite and honeysuckle card here. And this is a card of the Sword of Truth here. Definitely giving me very kind of Ace of Swords vibes here. And this is a card of freedom, warrior of light, and stop holding yourself back. And I really love this because this gives me like this Mercury in Virgo, the power of the word, Venus in Libra. And, you know, I know I've been really kind of hitting hard on these affirmations and things, but it's when we hold our truth and speak these powering and empowering words into our existence, we do become free. Because with Mars, I'm thinking with Mars being in Cancer, it can lead to a lot of reactive energy if we're not mindful. But when we're coming from that space, we are a warrior of light. We can operate from this place of, I'm getting like purity is what's kind of coming to mind here. And when I say purity, it's being your authentic self, operating in your perfect self-expression. That's what I feel this kyanite here. And the interesting thing about kyanite is that it doesn't take, this one of the stones that doesn't require, I remember reading about this, it doesn't require any sort of cleansing or anything along those lines. It's just, it's just naturally has this sort of, it's really great protection stone. There's some other things. I've had to get back up on my crystal knowledge there. But this is giving me, because of the imagery, very Ace of Swords as well, that what you speak and what you envision into your world can happen. And that's where I feel with Scorpio, the more you invite these truths, these feelings, it's not that the opposite isn't going to turn up, but it helps you, it keeps you more equipped to cut through the light, but to cut through the haze, the fogginess in this. Let me get some tarot on this and get some details with us. Now, let's see what's going on here. All right, so you have the Six of Coins, the Six of Knives, the Seven of Baskets, and the Mother of Sticks. Now, with the Seven of Baskets, you see how this person here, they got all this, it's like, there's that fog. So that fog came back for a second. And she's thinking about all of the things that she wants to fill her cups with. All the ways that it's going to that raise her vibration. This is Venus in Scorpio. And where Venus is in detriment in Scorpio, where she's really her weakest at, or the weakest at in Scorpio, can she pull in Scorpio. And if you're really intentional with that, things can get moving for you in a way, I feel, with the Queen of Sticks, like you wouldn't imagine. You just, and it's not that it'll seem like things will just fall out of the sky, but it's just like, I'll give you an example. Speaking of the Mother Stick, she usually has sunflowers. Oh, I love that. She usually has sunflowers in her picture. I'm thinking the traditional kind of white, Rider White. But There was this place I used to work at, and it was this person's last day. Sun and Leo, they had this little Leo necklace. And so I was just kind of out and about. I was working by this market, and I was just like, you know what? Speaking of all the flowers, I was like, you know, I was like, at the time, I was like, I'm gonna get some flower, get her a sunflower, and to see where that goes. It was just like that intention. Something about that just felt right, and I didn't know her that well. But I went to go get a flower, and I was telling the flower person about who I was getting this for and where I was working at the time. And they were like, "Oh my gosh, we actually know such and such. Here, take this for free." I was like, "Oh my gosh." And that's how I feel like the universe, when you follow your heart, is what I'm getting. When you follow the sunlight, because sunflowers are always pointing towards the sun. When you follow your sunlight, the universe gives back with the six of coins is what I'm getting. But I feel like it's, again, it's what working from your truth. When you're operating from this higher sense of, when you're working from your higher self, and that's interesting, it's a stop holding yourself back. I almost feel like it's in maybe worrying about in what others think. An example that would pop up for me, or that I could think of, is that if you were to decide to become sober, and then, you know, you want, or let's say you're wanting to, but you're holding yourself back because you're worried about what your friends are thinking. But what do you think? Because this doesn't really necessarily affect them. This is more so about you. So now I feel this six of knives here is, it's a freeing yourself of not worrying about what other people think. What's your truth? And those that will stick by your side, they will. And if they don't, then they don't. But know that if there's spaces that are being made, then they will be filled because you're attracting something different now, is what I'm getting with this six of knives and with this energy in general here. And the mother of sticks, she's a powerful. In this deck, she's considered the most powerful of the mothers. And I've just got like a she's like creation in motion. And she's bold about it, she's fearless about it. She's one, you talk about knowing her truth. She has absolute faith that she's going to, whatever it is, she's provided for because she's moving. That's what I'm getting. It's not that she's just going on like this. There's nothing blind. I was thinking like a blind faith, but she knows. She sees what's gonna happen because she knows that. I'm actually, if she, yeah, I think that's. Yeah, I guess I don't need to emphasize it. She's got me feeling really passionate here. So, and that's something, and, huh? That might be something too. Try not to. I'm getting a work again. Work with that Scorpio energy. It can be where it doesn't have to be just anxiety. It could be something where, okay, I don't know how I'm about to do this thing, but man, it's gonna be fun figuring out. It's gonna be really exciting, the things that I learned. There's a lot of luck that's going on here with this. You got your lucky $2 bill, the dice are number seven. Take a gamble, take a risk. You know, this, oh yeah, this is because of the six of coins. This is the moon in Taurus. And the moon does some of her best man. After Cancer, she does really great work in Taurus. And we're talking about that, her exaltation point. But, let's get some more on this. Look at that. Thanks, Divine Self. Let's talk about that one. Oh, look at you watering your garden. I'm with it. You got the Ace of Sticks here. That's what got me excited. You got the Ace of Sticks, you have the Garden card, which is the world, the Nine of Sticks, and then the Four of Sticks. Now, this Four of Sticks, this is giving me cause to celebrate. Oh, how interesting. This is both, you got both of the cards here that where Venus is in her, at her, kind of at her weakest here, Scorpio and in Aries. And I think that this message here is that even though you may feel, it's like, let's say you're ready to change like a job, for example, and you may not be in the job that you're in yet, but it's celebrating like the job's already here with the Four of Sticks. It's not letting a present situation bring down your energy because it can change with the Nine of Sticks. It's finding a way to channel your energy so that you can get to the finish line. I'm getting some we're needing to be flexible in how we're and how you're kind of working with whatever this new start is, because this Ace of Sticks, that's Source giving you this fuel, giving you this inspiration. The fire, the sticks are inspiration. They're the things that heat. It's the vibration that you feel in your body when you're just like, oh my gosh, I just need to do this. I need to. Let me get a little bit more with this garden card. Let me see what's going on with that. Okay, wow. All of those. Okay, thanks, Divine Self. Yeah? Okay. Let's see. So, we're going to walk through this. Oh, Hubby's here, though. Okay, so, got a lot with this world. So, you have Eight of Knives, Six of Sticks, Father of Sticks, Miss Ida, the Four of Cups, Four of Cups, and then the Son of Sticks here. Now, the World card is the end card. We're bringing things to a close. And I feel this Son of Sticks, see how he's got his hand out? He's just like, okay, let's evaluate where we're trying to go here. What is this? What are some things that we're needing to close out in order to bring the change that we want here? The big house, this is Mars energy, to bring the change that we want. Miss Ida, what are the intuitive downloads that you're getting? What is your intuition telling you? Because this Four of Baskets here is giving me this energy of maybe you've been getting these hits here from the Ace of Sticks, but we're not paying attention to them. And even getting like almost feeling a little jaded by them, like not quite trusting the, something's up with the process there. That's interesting. My camera just cut out and then it cut back on, and it's not done that before. Usually once it's out, it just stays out. So that's something to think about. But the Father Sticks here, speaking of Hubby, you know, being here, this Mother and Father Sticks. That's interesting. The Mother and Father Sticks are giving me there's this union that's happening here. I'm even getting the word like this conjunction, like how the seeding process happens here. And this is the time to Oh, that's interesting. I got a thing of keeping any sort of like big feelings toward yourself, as far as like any sort of things that you're wanting to cook up right now. Just let them marinate right now. Let the thoughts stay pure. Let them be yours. And not let others maybe influence the direction of that. You may be seeing sevens, but they may be seeing, maybe not. I was thinking craps, but I've not played craps. So correct me if on how that whole thing is going. You would think I know something that didn't work in a casino. But the Eight of Knives here is definitely feeling a bit restricted. It's feeling that, and I think that it's freeing yourself with this Ace of Swords. And just again, when an inspiration comes in, trust that. That whole impulse with getting that flower, that I remember that day, that was a really pleasant day that I had just overall. And it just all started with the nudge. And it's just you keep having those nudges until they start getting bigger and bigger and bigger. It's Let's get some advice from Mars. I love that Mars is here. Let's get some advice from Mars. Love when the planets show up. Here, I'm with it. So you have the accept love card here. And let's switch back over. Because that's what I think I really enjoy the most about Scorpio is that, like the fixed signs, when they focus on something, they have staying power. They're the solid signs, Taurus, Scorpio, Leo, and Aquarius. They fuel what the cardinal signs start. They are the ones that are going to have that again, that tenacity to see it through and build it to something exceptional. And so if you start accepting more things that you love, start cooking from a place of love, from a place of passion is more so that I'm giving. This giving me like a Knight of Cups type of energy. But it's giving me, you start working with that, and then you work with Scorpio from a place of love and from a place of passion, and watch what grows from that. Watch what can really start. I think you would be really surprised, pleasantly surprised, by what you could cook up when you just a matter of speaking a different truth here. This energy is earth and air. I'm just even looking at that. It's air and water is what this kyanite, blue kyanite and honeysuckle card here. And so it's taking that thought and let those things flow through the body, I feel. It's letting that feeling that... I'm looking at this cabinet of chocolates, like feeling the sweetness of your... Because I like the celebrations here. The Six of Sticks, there's another one that was here. The Four of Sticks. Even this Ace of Sticks to the world, because this is like taking your baton and going to the world, going to seeing something to completion here, the World Saturn card. But yeah, that's interesting with the, where'd the big house go? The big house, oh, that's right here. It's this, a lot of instinctual energy with Miss Ida, the big house. So just, something to pay attention to. Yeah, getting a lot with this. And if you feel overwhelmed sometimes with the feelings that are coming in, finding some ways to just ground yourself. I think that just even just getting outside and getting your feet on the ground just so that you can feel the earth again, like, okay, that you're not just like all... Because sometimes you can get so, with the emotions, you can get so pulled inside of yourself that it's just like, hey... That can really help. So that's just something else that's coming to mind. But I think I'm going to leave that there. So if you like that, if anything resonated with you, give it a thumbs up. Share this thing if you know someone who maybe would benefit from this. And then subscribe there, King, Queen of Wands. Hit that bell button to get notified on all these videos each day. And then last little bit, if you want to know what's going on in the sky, the come over with the other planets, come on over to my other channel, Alchemist 8, where I do weekly videos talking about that, shocker. And I also do videos doing different planetary placements in different houses as well. That's been a little series that I've been kind of starting up there. I've been enjoying that a lot. So I kind of release those. I've been pretty. I've been consistent with those. I've been releasing about one a day. So definitely check those out and comment on those, and let's start up a live. That's what I'm trying to get. That's what's manifesting is that we're going to be having live soon and having all the. Those of you with the South Node and Capricorn in the first house all come together. Just South Node and Capricorn in general. That'd actually be dope. And all that housekeeping is down in the description box below. But let me get your surprise card here. Or cards here. So I can get you out of here. But yeah, if you are curious about my lunar group, come on over. I also... offer with that when you join, you get a pre-recorded of your nearest solar return that was happening. So if you have one that just passed or if you have one that's coming up, I'll do a pre-recorded video for that. And even thinking about if doing some lunar return stuff as far as oh, we get more. Lunar return stuff and just many, many other things. You get discounts for any of my, any future courses that you, or any future classes that you join and any courses that you happen to invest in. So all types of real cool goodies. And we just a nice group to just kind of chat about what's going on in the space. And I actually have got some other things that I'm in getting in the mix. So stay tuned for that. Thanks to myself. But we got a few things going on here. A lot of energy is coming through. But you have the, oh, fascinating. So you have the Rhodiola card here, which is a card of wisdom. It's ruled by Uranus and Mercury. You have the Mitragynia card here. And this is a card associated with Saturn and Neptune. It's about shape-shifting. And then you also have here the Skull Cap card, which is a card of stillness. And this is a card of, this card is ruled by Pluto and Saturn. And I like all the Saturn energy here. But let's talk about the Skull Cap first. I love that there's a that scorpion that's sitting in there. This stillness, I feel that this is, because again, the mind's gonna do what the mind's gonna do, but we have control over our words. We have control over what we can bring to an existence, what we manifest or what we affirm in our minds, and finding different ways to break up that chatter. And it takes work and it takes practice. It takes getting in this stillness. But what I'm feeling with this shape shift card, oh, I just got like an as above, so below, because I'm seeing this is your divine self here. And then this person here, the bottom here, this would be your physical self. I'm getting this energy of you shifting more into your higher truth. Saturn and Neptune are going to be forming a conjunction here. I think it officially happens on in 2026, and it's happening exactly at 0 degrees of Aries. And I think that's where, this is a time where there has been a lot of shape-shifting going on. But I really think that with Saturn having kind of caught up here and being in this period of time, kind of closing out here as we move from Saturn into Aries, I think that this Rhodiola card, this wisdom, you're going to want to take the wisdom that you've experienced from that and take that forward, because there are going to be some shape-shifting that's happening. And I feel like that's just growth that's happening. We're all evolving, and we're becoming wiser. We're tapping into the higher mind. Uranus is considered the higher octave of Mercury. And so there's a lot of clarity that's coming through here. I'm getting just like you're operating from this experience and be a warrior of light. You know, there's no need to hold yourself back. You know, just be living your truth and revel in the experience of that. So yeah, faith that made sense. So until next time, stay mindful out there. Keep raising that vibration through the roof. There's another one that I wanted to add on to there, but seize the day and the night. Oh, no, keep eyes on the moon. Keep eyes on the moon, and I will catch you on the... Oh, when am I going to catch you? On the next one, Moon Day.